Now then, YouTube, I am the Toff Man, and welcome back to Tottenham Simulated Manager Mode. Let me just have a look at my computer here, because I think I've hit, what, episode 48, I'm saying now? I think it's about 48, I'm sure it is. But this, guys, should be, this video actually, should be the last one of the series. I will be moving on to something else, which I will get to either in a separate video or at the end of this video. I haven't quite worked out what I'm going to do yet, but got a match here against West Brom, 25th. Not too bothered about, you know, finishing top in the league or anything like that. So what I'm going to do is swap everybody out for my second team. Have I really got nobody else? Oh, there we are. Kabul, Bruma. Just them two? Fine. Narsing, Aaron Lennon. De Bruyne. Mermic. Jardim's gonna get a game. Yao Vilna. Batello. Okay, oh, that'll do for this team. But I've got a funny feeling, guys, that I really aren't. I'm not going to go through to the semis of the Champions League, not against Chelsea. Got that funny feeling. But, pardon me. A lot of people saying that form isn't everything. Two red cards that they got. 3-0 in the end. Two for Agi, oi, oi, oi. He scored 3 minutes after he came on. Ledge. Mermic scored as well. But that's a win. A lot of people saying form isn't everything on some of the latest videos that I've been putting out. And I don't know. I really honestly don't know, guys. I cannot say whether or not... I can't seem to be able to figure out whether it's form that it is, whether it's overall it is, or whether it's just totally fucking random. Here we go. The game against Chelsea now. Quarterfinals. It's the first one. We're going to get the best team out that we can.
So what do those results mean to the league table?
It's going to be Hummels.
We have new leaders in
Tottenham
with 66 points. In second, climbing the table are Chelsea with 66
points. Nathaniel Klein, can he play? Can he seriously play left back?
In third, the former leaders
he can.
Arsenal with 66 points.
Oh, what type of energy do you got? He's alright with energy as well. Narsing, 50 points. De Bruyne, Casemiro, Gareth Bale. Agi, and Jovetic. I mean, look at this squad. Look at the fucking squad. It's a piss take that we're even managing to get beat. You know what I mean? It's an absolute piss take that we're actually managing to get beaten, to me. So, Chelsea, next game. And it's going to be leg one of the semi-final. So, fingers crossed, guys. Come on now. Is this the season? The final season? Is this the season?
Queen's Park Rangers with 24 points. With a game in hand on the team above.
1-1. It all goes down to the next match. But they've got an away goal. April the 1st. QPR.
Borussia Dortmund 3. Manchester United 0.
And then this next game after this one could be the last, guys, of this series.
So what comes next in the Barclays Premier League?
It could well be. I'm fingers crossed that it's not. I really hope that it's not. Oh, we've got top of the table. Just on goal difference, it seems. Let's get the second team back out. Looks like what's-his-face has gone up again. Where's Mbastard Bay? Oh, there he is. He's on the other side. Let's swap these guys around so they're naturally good place. De Bruyne's gone up to 88. Holy shit. Mermic gone up to 80. Batello. There we are. That's the team that's going to be taking on the league for this game, at least. Ahem. 2017, a nil draw against QPR, away from home. Victor Soriano. I was looking forward to seeing that guy, but to be honest, I think it's about time that I put an end to this series, one way or another, and it could be this match that is the end. It could well be, or it could go on for a little bit longer. But we're going to put our best squad out for this match, of course, and hope for the best. Samuel Klein, Narsing, De Bruyne, Casemiro, Gareth Bale. There's no excuse that we should lose this, or anywhere near. So, I'm going to be playing this match in full length, guys, because this is a very, very important match. Could be the last one of the series. Chelsea versus Spurs. To be honest, looking at their team, looking at mine, we should be absolutely wiping the floor with these. Manchester United gone 1-0 up against Dortmund. If it stays as it is, oh, there we are, there's the away goal. So even if they score, it would take it to extra time. Fingers crossed, guys, fingers crossed that we can keep this lead. It is 1-0. Aggie, scoring the goal. It's 2-0 now. Charlotte 2-1. If Chelsea score again in the last minutes, they don't, and Spurs go through to the semi-finals. Here we are, guys, finally. Semi-final time. Eventually we managed to push through. Who are we going to be against, though? That is going to be for another day.
The draw has been made for the semi-final of the Champions Cup. Tottenham,
we're against Juventus.
Meanwhile,
in the semi-finals, and I'm feeling that this is the best chance we're ever going to get to the final of a Champions League, and for it to be the final season as well that I'm going to be doing this series for. It's fitting. It is fitting. Oh, advance again, please. I'll put my second team out.
So what comes next in the Barclays Premier League? In third place, Chelsea entertain 10th place, Aston Villa.
Let's get this. Oh, pull out the other way around. Lennon, Sandro, Mermich, Morales, Vilna, and Botello. And then there's Liverpool after that. Two-nil win. Klein and Botello are both scoring goals for Spurs. 2-0 win away from home. Sandro's picked up a suspension, so he won't be there available for the next match.
The Barclays Premier.
So April the 12th and April the 18th.
Swansea City 1. Bolton Wanderers 1. Norwich City 1. Cardiff City 0. Manchester City 2.
Yeah, I suppose we can do that.
So what comes next in the Barclays Premier League? Fourth place Everton visit.
It's going to be an interesting time. Daniel Klein, he's got Narsing in. De Bruyne, Casemiro, Gareth Bale, Jovetic, and Aggie. Where's Aggie? It's a bit footless, so let's bring Vilna on for this match, I think. Let's give Aggie the rest he deserves. There's nobody else to bring him on with, apparently. Oh well. Simulate this match against Liverpool. They bought De Schillio off me, didn't they? 2-1, and it was De Schillio who actually scored against us, a little fuck. Bale and Vilna both scoring goals. Aggie came on, and the 47th minute as well, I was hoping he was going to get a bit more of a rest than that. But we're going to go forging ahead to the game against Juventus now. Important game. Important game.
West Bromwich Albion 1. Cardiff City 1. Stoke City 1. Chelsea 2.
Arsenal.
They are capable of being beaten. Is this the season?
Let's look ahead to the semi-final.
Is this the season to be jolly? I hope so. Okay, so that's the best team that we've got there. They're on goodish form as well. Apart from Yarvill, who needs to be out for Aggie, 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 oi, oi, oi. Aggie, Aggie, Aggie. Aggie, Aggie, Aggie. Right, come on now. We can fucking do this. Important games. Important games, guys. Spurs versus Juventus. They've actually got a pretty good front line there. But 3-0, that's going to be hard for Juventus to come back from. 3-0 is an amazing achievement. Are we 1 foot into the Champions League final? Hummels and Bale both scoring. Vertonghen managing to get himself booked. But luckily I do have Bruma there. He is banned for the next match. So I'm a bit annoyed at that.
Champions Cup semi-final. Tottenham Hotspur 3, Juventus 0.
And it's second team time again when we go into this game against Norwich here. Apart from what's-his-face, Vertonghen, who's going to be playing this game. Because he's not going to be the one that's playing against Juventus, of course. But 3-0 is going to be hard for Juventus to come back from. Are they going to come back? We don't know. Don't know until this next game. Have I not got another? No, I haven't, have I? Of course I haven't. They're both on the pitch. Aaron Lennon. No Mitch. There we are. Norwich versus Spurs. This next match after this one could be the last, but with it being 3-0 up, I'm hoping. Unbelievable. I'm hoping not. I'm hoping that we can finally get to that elusive Champions League final after this match. Who knows, guys? Who knows?
Juventus will play Tottenham Hotspur.
This is chance and this is time, I'm thinking, for something good to happen. For once, can Tottenham win this Champions League? Can I finally put this series to rest on a high, or will it be a low? Nobody knows until the end of this game. 3-0, it's going to be hard to come back from. And of course, with it being such an important game, I will be playing it, well, not playing it, but I will be, you know, watching it go ahead. We just need to stop them from scoring. Any quick goals from Juventus and it'll be shaky. Just keep that back line, keep the defence. And there is Aggie, Aggie, Aggie. 4-0 on aggregate now. Going up to half time. It's gone past half time. It's still the 1-0 to Spurs. Juventus have to score 4. Not even that. And it's 2-0 now. It's 2-1. Juventus surely are out now. And Spurs, finally. Finally, we are in the Champions League final. Here we are. What a way to sign off the series. What a way. Either which way, either which way, I'm happy with finally getting to a final for the Champions League. It's about time. It really is. We've had some terrible, terrible draws.
So what comes next in the
but this season just seems to have been a really good draw. I thought we'd lost it with the result against whatever the fuck they're called. Can't remember. But we came back and won by one goal. We won 3-0 that game. So let's have a look at the calendar here and see exactly what we've got. We've got quite a few games before we've got to face off against Borussia Dortmund in the final of the Champions League. That's not going to be until the next episode, guys. I was hoping to get everything finished in this episode, but it looks like I'm not going to be able to do that. Who am I against? Arsenal. And then fucking Man United after that. Lovely. Fuck it, I ain't bothered about the league. What I am bothered about though is keeping my best players fit for this game against Borussia Dortmund. So let's swap a few of these guys around. Game against Arsenal. It's probably not going to go our way, to be quite honest, and it's a clash at the top between us all. And to put this team out against Arsenal is pretty stupid, but still. Only 1-0 we lost in the end for the 5th minute goal. We still managed to hold the ground.
The Barclays Premier League. Cardiff City 1. Sunderland.
Training injury. Kabul is out for 3 months, and that's the exact reason why I don't want to give these people. I certainly don't want to end up with any injuries when I'm going into this match against Dortmund. 1st of May. Now we've got a game against Manchester United, who are clinging on. Look, I mean, they're not even. They're 6th at the minute, Man United.
Arsenal face a trip to 18th place, Wigan Athletic.
6th.
2nd place, Chelsea, visit 12th place, Norwich City. In 3rd place, Tottenham.
Tottenham, has he gone down?
5th place, Manchester United.
Bastard.
4th place, Liverpool, visit 15th place, Sunderland.
Let's get this sorted out properly here. It's not Mbe either. Where is he? Nathaniel Klein. Oh, he's gone up to 82. Ledge. Gareth Bale, Milner's gone up to 81. It's an insane squad. It's an insane squad, but this is going to be the last game before I stop and go on to the next one. A 1-0 win, De Bruyne. Getting the goal there, and that is lovely stuff. I always like beating Manchester United. I always do like beating Manchester United. But now, I'm afraid it is, guys, time to say goodbye for this episode, but join us for the next one, which is going to be the final episode, guys, of this Tottenham playthrough. That's part 49. It would have been lovely to get to a part 50 and round it off on a good, nice number there. But alas, it's not to be. Till next time, I've been the Top Man, as always. Stay safe.